Hello everyone, I am going to explain question number 1 from exercise 9.1 of 12th class maths. So as you can see, the question is integrate the following with respect to x. So we have to integrate these functions with respect to x. So there are 4 parts. We will start from the first part. So here the first part is the first part we are starting, that is we have to integrate cube root of x square. So first of all, we can write this cube root of x square as, we write it in the form of power 4. So when we write it in the power notation, it's going to be x to the power 2/3, because cube root is going to be 1/3. So 2 multiplied by 1/3 is 2/3. So this I wrote in the power notation. Now why I wrote it? Because students, we know that since the integration formula of x to the power n with respect to dx is x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 and plus c. C is the constant of integration. So this formula we are going to use in this. That's why I wrote the function in the power notation to get my n. So here, what is n for us? 2/3. So we write down on integrating. So directly we, because it's only one mark question, so directly no need to write down on integrating with respect to it. Directly just use the symbol of integration. So integration of x to the power 2/3 with respect to x is, so this formula we are going to use. So according to this formula, x to the power n plus 1, whatever power is there in that you have to add. So here what's the power is 2/3. So first I will write here x, then 2/3 plus 1, and in down also n plus 1. N plus 1 means 2/3 plus 1 and plus c, that is integration constant. So this we have to simplify. So when we simplify, we have to take the LCM. So after taking LCM, we will obtain here 5/3 and here also 5/3. So we will write here x to the power 5/3 and here also 5/3 plus c. Now when we simplify it, so this fraction when we divide, this 3 will come in the multiply, because we have to do the reciprocal of this denominator fraction. So when we do the reciprocal of the denominator fraction, it is going to be 3/5. So reciprocal of this, and this x to the power 5/3 as it is, and this power should appear as the power. So it's got wrong. I erase and I write again. It should be very properly written 5/3. So and plus integration constant, and plus c always we have to write down. This is named as integration constant. So that's it. So first part completed. Now we'll start the second part. Second part is e to the power 3s. So second part, here the function is e to the power 3s. So when we'll integrate it with respect to x, this is the integration symbol, and the 3x with respect to x we are different integrating, that's why dx will come. So this is named as, how to read it, integration of e to the power 3s with respect to x. Again I'm repeating how to read it, integration of e to the power 3s with respect to x. So when we'll integrate it, first I'm writing the formula of integration of e to the power x. The formula of integration of e to the power x is only directly e to the power x and then plus integration constant. So when we'll integrate, again it's going to be same e to the power 3x, but since it's not x, it's 3x. So in integration also we have to apply the chain rule, but the chain rule will not come in the multiplication. This time the chain rule will come in the divide. So like this it will have going to be. So e to the power 3x integration is same, that is we'll get again e to the power 3x but it's not x, it's 3x, so we have to apply the chain rule. And in differentiation, the chain rule used to come in multiplication, but in the integration, the chain rule will come in the divide. That's why, so when we differentiate it, so differentiation of 3x is only 3. So this 3 will come at the dividing and plus integration constant. So that's it. This is the answer. So how this 3 came? Because of the chain rule, we differentiated this 3x. When I differentiated this 3x with respect to x, only 3 answer will come. And since we are integrating, so in integration, this 3 will come in the divide. That's why divided by 3. So this is your direct answer, and this is write down in the reason the formula, and it's sufficient. Now we move to the third part. Third part is 1 upon 2 to the power x, and to differentiate it, to integrate it, sorry, we are going to use the formula. So we'll move for the next slide. In this space is not there. Now the third part, again I am writing here because I need the question. I need the question, that's why I am writing again the third part. Third part is we have to integrate 1 upon 2 to the power x. And students, for this I am going to use the formula. Since integration of a to the power x with respect to x is a to the power x itself and divided by log a and plus c. So by keeping this formula in our mind, we will integrate. So first we will relate what is our a and what is our x. So here student, x is itself x, and what is a for us? What is a? A means base. So what is base here? 1 upon 2. So we will use this formula. So when we will integrate it with respect to x, the answer is going to be ax. Ax means what is a here? 1 upon 2. So it's going to be 1 upon 2 x, then log a in divide. So log 1 upon 2. That's it. And then plus c. We cannot simplify it. So this is your answer. So directly formula we had used. So in this we have to use the formula of ax, and what is a here? A is 1 upon 2. Now we'll solve the fourth part of the same question. The fourth part is we have to integrate a to the power 2 log the base is a and x. So this function we have to integrate. So here students, first we simplify it. So there are some formulas of logarithm which I am writing here, and you just learn it. The formula is m, then log m, and here suppose take n. So its answer is only n, because it's here also m, and the base of log is also m. In that situation, whatever number is here, that is going to be your answer. So in this we are going to use this formula. So it's first we'll convert our function in this format. So first I am writing the question here. The question is a to the power 2 log, then base is a and x. So to use this formula, in front of log nothing is there. So we have here 2. So this 2 I am shifting here because we have one more formula. So one formula I am going to use this. The other formula is suppose n log m is there. Then we can write it as log m to the power n, because this number is going to be as power. So according to this, this 2 will go as the power of x. So first I am using this second formula, then I will use this first formula. So it's going to be a, then log a x to the power 2 here, Now here students see, here also and this base is also a, that's why it's going to be only x square. Now we'll integrate it, so which implies integration of a to log a x with respect to x is equal to, we have simplified it, so that simplified answer is right here, it is x square integration with respect to x. Now to integrate it, what formula we are going to use? Since the integration of x to the power n with respect to x is x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c, here 1 will come, plus c is the integration constant. So here what is n for us? 2. That's why x to the power n plus 1 means 2 plus 1 divided by n plus 1, that's why 2 plus 1, then plus integration constant c is equal to, we will simplify the powers, so 2 plus 1 is 3 and here also 3 plus c. So all 4 parts are completed, and students in your book in front page some formulas of integration are mentioned. So before doing this chapter, I request from you, learn all the formula so that integration will be clear to you. And further, if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment so that we can clear out. Thank you.